Hello and welcome to today's video. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about one of the most popular videos on my channel, which is where I shared my results from doing the DNA testing 23andMe. I get comments on that video all the time and most of them are pretty crappy and negative. So today I'm going to respond to the hate. Now, I don't like to do so much negative stuff on this channel, but I just wanted to do this for fun, and I'm going to also update a little bit of information and share with you some of the things that I really liked about doing the test. So let's start with that. First of all, I had a great experience doing the 23andMe test. I thought it was worth the money that I paid, and I was happy with the amount of information that I found out. And if you want to find out all the results and stuff, you can check that first video out. I was also able to get connected with two relatives on my mom's side, which was pretty cool. I am in contact with my mom, so it would have been possible somehow to maybe get in contact with those family members, but they're like third cousins, and it was actually just really cool to be able to get connected with them through the service. It was really easy, and there's actually a few other people that I had been talking to recently trying to figure out if we were possibly related. So that part I thought was really awesome, and one of the main reasons why I decided to do the test was because I don't know my biological father, and I just thought it was kind of a cool way to learn more about myself without knowing my biological father. That was honestly my first reason for wanting to do the test. So a lot of people complained that I needed to update my video because the pricing had changed since I last filmed the video. Well, obviously pricing changes and there's no way for me to go into that video that's on my channel already and update. But yes, the pricing has changed. When I paid for it, it was $99, and the prices had gone up. So to get the same exact testing that I did, it's now $199. But you do have a choice, and I have my phone here, I'm gonna look up a couple things. You do have a choice of what you can, or which testing that you do. So there is an option to do one of the tests that's $99, and that includes just the ancestry service. But you can also choose to do what I did, which was the health and ancestry service for $199. Personally, if I were to do it again, I would choose the more expensive one because I just feel like it's more beneficial to get as much information as you can while you're doing the test one time. So you do get to find out information about different diseases and stuff. You get to find out if you have a certain percentage you get to find out if you are possibly a carrier for different diseases, which I felt was kind of beneficial and nice to do while I was already doing the test. So again, I would definitely suggest if you're going to do it, just do the full test, $199. It's a one-time thing. You don't have to pay any monthly fees or any subscriptions like that. And you do get access to your reports. I'm not sure if it's a lifetime, but I did this over a year ago and I still have access. I can go on here and pull up everything. And something that's kind of cool is I noticed that I randomly get emails and it will say, hey, we have this new information that you can figure out now, or that you can see the results to now. So they are continually being able to tell you more and more, which I thought was really awesome. So now that we got that out of the way, sorry, I'm a little jumbled with my words today. We are going to head on over to the comments. I'm not going to read all of them and, you know, respond to all. Some of them are pretty nasty. I don't know. It's just the thing that happens when videos end up showing up on suggested video feeds. Random people just end up on the video and commenting, but we'll go through a few because I don't care. A lot of people were like, ooh, confirmed, she's white. Okay. It's kind of funny. Let's see. 0.02% Sub-Sahara African. Somebody in her family had jungle fever. Woo! People did get really upset because people really, like, read into that video so much. I think it was really hard to read the report at first, and so when I was reading the results on camera, I would be, like, reading, and then I would, like, kind of slow down for a minute, and I was like, 0.02 Sub-Sahara African, and people were like, oh god, she sounds really unhappy about that, like, are you racist or something? And it's like, No, I was just reading through the results and it's really hard. It was really hard to, I don't know. It was confusing a little bit at first for me to read the results. There we go. Someone said they raised their price tremendously. We already went over that. So you found out you're white again. Interesting. I mean, whatever. I actually found out a lot more than that, but that's okay. Need to update. Your price is now, the price is now $199. Let's see. And it's not really my responsibility to update, but you know, prices change. Someone said, did you say broccoli European? I thought that was kind of funny. It's frustrating they say British and don't break it down to Scottish, Welsh, or English. Now, I'm not 100%. I'm pretty sure that it is broken down. When I was going over the results on the video, I was just kind of reading the main information that I was seeing. So they do give you a lot of information, and I feel like it's pretty detailed. Someone said, I just want to know about the medical problems I will face as I age. Ancestry is cool and all, but not worth $200 price tag. Whether I will develop cancer or not, far more interesting. Yeah, I don't know. You know, you're not going to find out if you for sure are going to be getting these diseases that they tell you you might be a carrier for. But I think it's kind of a cool thing because if you find out that you may be a carrier for a certain thing, then you can look into that a bit more. Okay, the 0.2% African thing didn't throw her off at all. Obviously, that person's being sarcastic. Yeah, it didn't throw me off. I mean, I don't... Oh, someone else said, why did she get all sad when it read 2% African? And I don't think it's 2%, it's 0.02 or 0.2, which, there we go again. Someone's probably going to read into that and be like, why are you so racist? Definitely not at all. oh, someone said, you didn't say you were 0.2 African. Were you bummed about that? Because you didn't say anything about it. And when I was reading through the reports, I was kind of looking at them a little bit earlier today, and I noticed that the 0.2 African, it's further down on the page. So when I was initially reading that on my video, I probably was just like scrolling down and just read it. Let's see. Someone else said, so you're a black Jew. oh, someone said, you look like the female mouse from Flushed Away. I thought that was kind of funny. I don't actually know that, but whatever. Let's see. Paying a website to confirm you're white seems fun. Someone else said, you look some Asian, question mark. I just thought that was a funny one. Yeah, so, how you didn't show us your maternal haplogroup DNA. Yeah, I wasn't wanting to show everything. How can anyone trust this thing? From what I've read, the test is pretty accurate. I don't know, the main thing for me, it was cool to get in touch with two family members that I wouldn't have, and it was just a fun experience. I'm definitely not upset about the information that I got from it, and like I said, I also didn't share all of the information. I didn't share anywhere near all of the information that I got from it. So there's a lot of comments, so obviously, you know, there's a bunch of random, someone else said, you're African. That's cool, and if I ever get extra money, I would do it. I definitely understand or recommend doing it if you want. I mean, let's see. Someone said, so you're part Jewish? Someone said, do you have to pay extra for them to inform you of the genetic diseases you may pass on to children? And that is one part of the test, and that would have been included in the $199 kit. So not extra, but you have to choose which kit. So yeah, someone else said, how long does it take to get them to stop analyzing and start doing the work? I don't know what that means. Let's see, how long did it take to get back the results? It took about a month and a half. Someone said they totally raised the price now. I mean, they raised it, but that happens. Someone made fun of how I pronounced the word Ashkenazi. And I'm pretty sure I probably still said it wrong, but big deal. Yeah, so some of these are kind of terrible. Oh, a lot of people made fun of how I pronounced the word that I probably just pronounced wrong again, but, let's see. I'm just scrolling through here. See if there's anything else that's worth responding to. I think we pretty much got most of what I want to respond to. I know this video is pretty long, so there we go. I thought you might enjoy this little update, especially if you're someone that actually likes me. You're not just here as a troll. But thanks, guys, and obviously my final thought on that is that I would recommend doing it if you want to learn more about yourself, if you want to find out possible genetic things that you could pass on to children. I would recommend it. So thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.